Tuning a car has gotten a lot easier nowadays. And with technology advancing, tuning has become a much more popular topic. Some cars can see gains of up to 100 wheel horsepower with just a tune on the car's ECU. So I wanted to make this video to shed some light on the different methods that people use to tune their cars, including my Escort. But I'm no expert at tuning. I know the basics, but not enough to feel qualified to talk to you guys about it. So we decided to go to somebody who's much more qualified, Jermaine Riddick, the head tuner at Turbo XS.
My name is Jermaine Riddick, and I am the head tuner for Turbo XS. Been tuning since 2004. It's a different time, I mean, because there wasn't a lot of people tuning. So the ones who did were special, I would say. They were special because they had a little more insight to the vehicle and how the vehicle worked before. And I guess the guys now are, it's not as special because if you have a laptop and if you have a cable, you can be a tuner.
Over the years, tuning has evolved, and in that time, we've seen many different methods for tuning. There are three primary methods that we're going to talk about in this video: piggyback, flash tuning, and standalone. So, Jermaine has a few options for tuning on his 2017 Golf R.
Take for example, we have this Golf R that we are planning on modifying. Had the option of using the JB4, which is a piggyback ECU, and allows you to control fuel and the boost on it. It's really simple. It's plug and play, so you disconnect the sensor, plug the JB4 in the middle of it, and then you can be off and running within seconds. But the cool thing about that is that if you have to take it back to the dealer, you just disconnect the connectors, pull the JB4 out, plug in the factory sensors back where they're supposed to be, and you're done.
The next option, and probably the most common option, was just made available for the Golf R, a flash tune using the Cobb access port.
The access port is an ECU reflash that has a brilliant module that gives you an interface that allows you to change your maps on the fly. So you could go from your stage 1, 2, to 3 with the module in hand and also have a gauge. The JB4 doesn't allow you to do that. The access port allows you to change all of the ECU parameters versus just changing a 2 or 3 that the JB4 would allow you to do. This Golf R is currently on the JB4, and we're going to switch it over to the access port that just came out for the Golf R.
So we're going to show you the process of changing the map on the access port. So we're going to plug it in. Go down to your tune. Stage 191 high boost. Just like that, you're on the new map. You do not need to keep this installed in the vehicle. You can always take it out, put it in your glove box, keep it from getting stolen.
The last method of tuning is standalone. For the Golf R, standalone ECUs are very rare. They're more commonly used on cars that don't otherwise have the support or functionality to tune using the first two methods. My Escort is one of those cars. All right, so we're back in my garage in the Escort now, and I wanted to show you what the Escort is currently running on. It doesn't have the factory ECU at all. It's on the standalone ECU, which is called Megascort. I didn't name it, that's just what it's called. And this box here essentially gets rid of the factory ECU, and this is what's running everything instead. So this way I can connect that to my computer and make all sorts of adjustments that the factory ECU wouldn't otherwise normally be able to make. So it's just standard USB that plugs right into your computer. So you set up some software here and you can change quite a lot of parameters, more than the factory ECU would allow you to. So I've got boost by gear, boost by RPM, flat foot shifting, launch control, sequential fuel injection. All of this stuff I wasn't able to do on the factory ECU, so that's why I went with the standalone.
Standalone ECU replaces the factory ECU, and the reason why you would do that is if you don't have the exact controls that you want to over the engine. In most high horsepower situations, when you start getting in the 600 to 1,000 horsepower, where you think you will have the limitation with the factory ECU or a piggyback, the standalone is a perfect place for that. On 95% of the vehicles that you have the ability to flash the ECU, that's all you need. Probably up to 500 horsepower, which is pretty easy. But once you start getting above that or you don't have the ability to flash it, that's when you need a standalone. And there's certain vehicles like your Ford Escort, which you don't really have the ability to flash the ECU, so you have to find other ways to have the exact control that you want.
So what's the best method for tuning your car? Well, that depends on your application and what you're looking to do with the car. But hopefully this video helps show you a couple different options that you have. For me, I would get the access port any day of the week. And I'm not just saying that because this video is sponsored by Cobb. I've been using the access port long before we were in contact with them, and that's because it's a great product. If they made an access port for the Escort, that's what I'd use. And if I had a Golf R, there isn't a question.